everyone, so today I'm gonna do my first like products, empties and reviews kind of videos. How many videos am I doing today? Okay, so I'm gonna do a video. I've been wrapping up this stuff for a while. Some of it's not even that exciting, it's just like, you know, everyday stuff that you'd use, but I just wanna give you my thoughts on the products that I've purchased and how they work and all that kind of stuff. And I'm heading out to, this is so deja vu right now, okay. I'm heading out to a work dinner, fucking surprise, but my makeup's done and I have some time to kill and I really, really need to make a video, so I thought, why not do this? I've been meaning to do the product empties review, product empties and review video for a while because I've had this stuff collecting and building up, so yeah, let's just jump straight into it. Okay, the first product I have is actually something really basic. I'm sure we all have it, a lot of girls would have the exact same thing. It's the Rexona Motion Sense Deodorant Sexy Bouquet. That's the scent I decided to get. Pretty standard, it's deodorant, does what it does, makes it not stink. Yeah, generally speaking, like, you know, I work in a supermarket and you sit on the register and all that kind of stuff, but sometimes we start early and we stock the shelves and, you know, it's a lot of hard work sometimes, do get a little bit sweaty and, yeah, I can confidently say that I spray this on in the morning, by the end of the day I'm still smelling a-okay, so, yeah, I'd say the deodorant is doing a relatively good job. Next little product I have in my bag is the Rihanna perfume. Oh, this is awful. I actually forgot what the shade's called. I think it's called Nude, that's for sure. It's called Nude. So this is my first little bottle, and since then I also received a bigger bottle. Hang on. There's like nothing in there. You know when you've got like that remnants of like a little bit of liquid like floating around the bottom? Yes, got some out. All right, I'm wearing this for dinner tonight. Oh, it's honestly so nice. Like, my best friend bought it the day I went into her house and she's like, look what I got, because it's honestly that nice. Like, I recommend if you see it in the shops, like, give it a little. Oh my god, you see my cat? Oh my god. Oh my fucking god. The awkward moment when I'm in the middle of filming and fucking Andy, my cat, like, meows so loud in the background and I shit myself on camera. Okay, if you're in the shops, I recommend you give it a little sniff because it's very nice. Yeah, so as you just saw, I was like Snapchatting all my pals about my cat experience. I'll leave my Snapchat name there if you guys want to add me and just follow and see what I do. I don't know. So the next product I have in my bag is the Napoleon Set Contour and Highlight Palette. Pretty much since I started YouTube, I've used it in nearly every single video because it's pretty much like a holy grail product for me. This blush honestly is awesome. Shimmer Highlight Powder actually cracked. But yeah, that's really, really nice too, quite finely milled. Yeah, the contouring powder is really, really good. It's kind of like halfway between cool and warm, so neutral, as they say. But yeah, I'm always scraping the corners on that one because I really, really like it. This one, it's alright. Like, obviously nothing wrong with the colour, it's just white, but nothing special. It's not like that buttery or anything. But for these three products, definitely worth it. It's only like 28 bucks from Target or something like that because it's the Napoleon set, so yeah. Next up, I have the Batiste Dry Shampoo, like everyone has in their empties haul. I just wanted a normal dry shampoo, and I bought it because I really, really liked the packaging. Yeah, it's just a dry shampoo. Like, I wouldn't be like, oh my fucking god, it's the art of this world. But yeah, it did the job. Like, it's dry shampoo, and Batiste is definitely up there. Like, I keep going back to that brand. So yeah, have made repurchases since this bottle, and will continue to do so. Oh my fucking god, guys. Okay, I really want to make a holy grail products video because that Napoleon set thing would have been included in it, and this next product 110% would take the cake, top of the rank, would be included in that video. It is the Hourglass Mineral Veil Primer. Now I'm fucking telling you, when you see it on YouTube and people hype it up, it's no joke. Please go out and get it. I don't care if you have dry skin, I don't care if you have oily skin, it makes your skin smooth as fuck. It holds your makeup. If you have oily skin, it's a freaking godsend. You need it. I'm serious. And this little travel size was only like $25. Because, look, I can sit here and tell you it's like freaking amazing, but so have so many other YouTubers. And I still wanted to go for the small size to try it for myself. Because, you know, there is the off chance that it might not work for you. I don't think a massive chance, but yeah, like maybe go the travel size if you just want to try it out or you're not sure, or if you have another primer that you think might work better for you. But honestly, it's worth the hype. It's amazing. After I bought this one, I bought the full size, which is like $69. Then there's like a big size, and then they came out. My cats are going nuts tonight. They came out with an even bigger size. It's like $96. I haven't got around to getting that one, but look, I would. It's good shit. Okay, next up I have another dry shampoo. It's the Polished London. I don't know, I'm probably disgusted and that's because I am. I'm not saying it's like the worst fucking thing ever, but it's just, it's like $5. I'm not disgusted, like it's dry shampoo, kind of does the job, but I can't even remember my major issue with it. I just remember thinking, nah, I'm not going to repurchase this. I'm going to stick with Batiste. And like Batiste is, I don't know, it can range between $10 and $13 depending where you buy it. So at most you're paying an extra $8, which kind of sounds like a lot, but okay, well there you go. This one's 150 mils and the Batiste is 200. So it's like, yeah, you're paying extra, but you are getting extra. Like I'm not saying like the quantity and money is matching. Like if you got 200 in this, obviously it wouldn't be $10, $13. But I'm just saying this one is worth it because this one just, yeah, it's no good. I won't be repurchasing it. Okay, next up I have the Maybelline Instant Age Rewind Concealer. Everyone will probably know about this. It's pretty like hyped up. I don't know, hyped up, but pretty well known on YouTube. Yeah, the one I'm currently using is in Fair Claire. So I'm pretty sure they discontinued Light Pale, which I know was a disappointment to a lot of people. I remember seeing people mention it and being like, oh, I really like that shade, blah, 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 blah. So anyway, we're talking about the formula here. The formula is really, really nice. Like it's easy to blend. It doesn't, I don't know, people might disagree with me. I seem to have this problem with a lot of concealers, which is weird. I don't feel like I have anything to cover, but then I seem to think a lot of concealers have shit coverage. I don't know, I just find that it honestly isn't my brush or my foundation, it doesn't matter what I use. I just often find that like, I'll put a bit of foundation, I'll try and get it up under my eyes so I've got that coverage to begin with, then chuck the concealer on top, and as I blend it out, it just kind of takes away the coverage of my foundation and goes see-through. I'm not saying this does this, I'm just saying it doesn't really add any coverage. Like it's not that great with coverage, but again, I don't really need it. So, but yeah, all around, really good product, definitely would recommend it. Okay, next up I have the e.l.f. Under Eye Concealer and Highlighter. I stuck with the concealer for a while because it was a good shade, it was quite light, it brightened up the under eye area, but like I mentioned with the last concealer, I do feel like it takes away your foundation a bit and the coverage is just like not there. I'm not saying I need it because I don't really have dark under eye circles, but for other people, most people say they want coverage in their concealers. So if you want coverage, this isn't for you. The highlight side, if you apply your liquid foundation and then put it on the cheekbone, blend it out, again, same thing. It's basically going to make your foundation go see-through. It doesn't give you any highlight. It just affects the purpose. The highlight side, I've heard other people say it. It's just like, rip it the fuck off. It's not going to work for you. If you want to buy it, the concealer's not too bad, but the highlight is going to do absolutely nothing for you, unfortunately. Oh yeah. Okay, so I've just seen that there's 5 more products left in my bag, and they're all really good ones. So, okay, we're up to the Bondi Sands Self Tanning Foam in Dark. I remember last, like, autumn, winter, I, like, lived off this stuff. I had a fake tanning, not routine, like, not on YouTube or anything, but I'm just saying, like, I did it weekly, I loved this stuff, had absolutely no problems with it, still have absolutely no problems with it. I'm just kind of happy to try some other stuff, but it's really good, pretty easy to blend, really nice formula, fades off pretty good, yeah. I honestly thought I'd have more to say about this. Like when I saw it, I was like, yes, I have to bump my sands, oh yeah. But yeah, honestly, it fucking stinks. Like I don't like the smell. It pretty much just smells like all fake tan. I'm not saying this has any major issues, but it's coconutty and it's gross and I hate fake tan smell. But yeah, definitely does the job. It's pretty dark. If you're like, it's so dark when you first put it on. When you wash it off, you definitely lose the guide color. But if you layer it up a bit, you should be right. But I'm just gonna stop because I'm seriously making it sound bad. It's a fucking awesome tan. Get on it. If you haven't got on it, I feel like you've been living under a rock. It's so famous and so hyped up. You need to get it. It's really good. Okay, next up I have the CoverGirl Lash Blast Mascara. Lash Blast? Yeah, I know it's the Clump Crusher. That's definitely a tongue twister. The oh my god. Okay, the Clump Crusher. Yeah, Clump Crusher Extensions Lash Blast. I'm fucking good enough to be on the ad. You see, I got through that with absolutely no mistakes. Like, I have the smallest lashes ever, so mascara formulations really don't mean anything to me because, like, they're not going to make a difference. My eyelashes are just that short and they're not curly, so yeah, but I really like the wand on this one. I don't know if you can see. Yeah, you can kind of see now. It's very, like, comb-like and it's very thin. So whilst it does a fine job, absolutely, on the upper lashes, I do really like it for the lower lashes because it's got that kind of comb style wand. Okay, next up I have the St. Ives Blemish Control Apricot Scrub. It's just, yeah, it's a fucking bomb exfoliator. Like, when you squeeze it out, I don't know, imagine like sand in a cream. I don't know how to explain it. It's so good. It's really, like, I don't know, I'll see if I can get some out. Yeah, it's really like, it's got a lot of grains in it. It's really good at exfoliating the skin. Yeah, I don't really have anything major to say about it. It's just a really good exfoliator, above average in my opinion, for sure. It's just so dense. Like, I have another exfoliant, which I'll show you next. I'll just mention it when I see you had. This one just compares better because it's just more dense. There's just more grainy bits. And it's just thicker and it just works, okay? I use it like every time I have a shower. Would definitely recommend you all try it. It's only like 10 bucks. Grab it in Priceline, Safeway. Yeah, it's good shit. Okay, so looking down properly, I realized that a couple of my products actually fell out of my bag. So when I said I only had like 5, I probably had like 7 or 8. So anyway, what I was saying about the last one, okay, this is the La Cura Purify Exfoliating Wash for Oily Skin. This is really good too. It's more like, okay, that one was like, think an exfoliating paste, yeah? This one's more like a gel with less grains. So the grains are still just as harsh. I don't like using the word harsh because I feel like that can turn people off, but coarse, I don't know what you'd say. But the grains are still just as coarse, but there's just not as many of them. Still plenty, of course, just the one I mentioned before is like pure grains in cream, whereas this one's just slightly less grains in more of like a gel formula. But yeah, this was really good, did the job. I'd still recommend it. $4, get on it. You've got Batiste Dry Shampoo, same kind of formula, but dark and deep brown. So it's got like a hint of color. I'm actually using a different bottle right now, which is medium brunette or something, and I don't really like it as much because it really is medium brunette. Like, it's very light brown. You can see the white powder throughout. Can't really remember how dark this one comes out in the hair, but it's bound to be darker. Generally speaking, I don't think that it's like, you know, spray on hair color. So no matter what, even if you get a dark one, you're still gonna get that slight appearance of like a white powder. Like, you can't really avoid it, but it's definitely worth getting the darker one if you have darker hair, because obviously the originals and the lighter ones, they just, yeah, you get that little like white streak on your hair. Ooh, a weird hairline today. Yeah, you get that like white streak on your hairline, so. Okay, only 2 more products, I promise. So this is the MAC Studio Fix Fluid. My shade is NC42, which is honestly, it's very yellow, but if you've got a strong fake tan on your neck, it's a really good match, I think. So I would recommend maybe going to the store and getting like a little swatch on like your jawline there to see if it matches your fake tan, because I think it would. Anyway, enough about the shade. The formula, it's really, really good. Like, I don't know, I remember seeing a video once where a girl was saying like, or like, it takes a while to build it up to full coverage. I disagree. Like, I reckon I just chuck a bit on my brush and it's like pretty full coverage straight away. The longevity is really good. Like, you know, you can splash your face with water a little bit. Like, just general wear and tear throughout the day, I don't feel like it fades off, or like, yeah, it fucking stays put, right? Studio Fix, good shit. For my final product is the, how does everyone else say it? Natio Natio. Natio. I say Natio, but anyway, the Natio Young for Oily and Combination Skin Moisturizer, just a oil-free moisturizer. This is so good. It is so moisturizing, and I really love the fact that it's made for certain skin types. I'm pretty, not 100%, but I'm pretty sure they have one for dry skin too, but even if they don't, sucker, they got one for me, which is oily skin. So yeah, it's honestly, it's 10 bucks. There's nothing like interesting to say about it. It's just a really good moisturizer. It absorbs into the skin really nice. Like, if you have a bit of bumps and stuff, I'm not saying they go away or anything, but it really just softens the skin and makes it supple. So yeah, my grandma bought me this when I was like 17, I think, and I've never looked back. I'm nearly 22 and I've been using it ever since. So yeah, definitely a holy grail product. Okay guys, so there we have it. That is the end of my products, empties and reviews video. Really hope you guys like it. Please give it a thumbs up for me if you enjoyed it, if you'd like to see something similar in the future. Leave any requests down below in the comments section. Subscribe so you don't miss out on any future videos. Yeah, I liked making this video, so anyway, that's kind of irrelevant, whatever. Just thought I'd let you know I enjoyed it and I'm not having a bad time talking to camera. So yeah, thanks so much for watching and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye!